Late breaking at 4, a brutal killing at a local computer store has remained unsolved for more than 2 decades until now. Good afternoon. I'm Jim Payne.
I'm Martha Sagowski. Seminole County investigators just arrested a man they say is connected to the 1991 murder. WESH News' Dave McDaniel joining us live right now with the late breaking details. And Dave, how did they track this guy down so long after the crime?
Well, Martha, this case had baffled investigators for so many years because they said they didn't have any clues, it wasn't a sexual attack, and nothing was missing. Even today, after this arrest, they say they have nothing that links the suspect to the victim, except science. Back in 1991, detectives described a bloody crime scene. 50-year-old Betty Foster, who was working at the MyComp computer store, was found stabbed to death.
We found a bloody crime scene and the victim lying deceased in the office area of this business.
Cops said nothing was missing, Foster didn't have any known enemies, and it was not a sexual attack. What they had was blood, lots of it. And today, 50-year-old David Lee Hedrick was arrested, accused of the murder nearly 21 years ago.
It just so happens that his DNA was collected from the crime scene, obviously enough to develop probable cause for his arrest for murder.
The DNA match came about late last year. Hedrick was arrested for tax evasion in 2009, and since all felony convictions now lead to DNA samples being taken, a routine computer comparison against the statewide database led to Hedrick popping up in the previously unsolved Foster case.
We're very confident. The five separate samples, as I said, from the crime scene matched to the same DNA sample that was collected from the defendant.
Confident in the arrest, even without any other connection.
There's no known association to the defendant and the victim, Betty Foster.
We stopped by Hedrick's home in South Seminole County. His family said they couldn't speak on camera without the permission of their attorney. The only thing they would say to me while I was talking with them at their front door was that they believed that David Hedrick's arrest has to be a mistake. An interesting notation in the arrest warrant. He just registered as a convicted felon last Thursday with the Seminole County Sheriff's Office. And while he was registering, apparently the person checking him in noticed old injuries to at least one finger on each hand, injuries they said that made it hard for him to straighten out those two fingers. Reporting live in Seminole County, Dave McDaniel, WESH 2 News.